Yes, good morning children. So today we will study the chapter that is the water resources of our country. The water resources of our country is divided into surface water and groundwater. What is the surface water? A surface water resource in India is the rainfall, which is the main source of fresh water in India. From precipitation, we get more amount of surface rainfall, which also includes your snowfall. Surface water. A good part of the surface water is lost because of the process of evaporation and plant transpiration. Surface water is available on the surface in the form of lakes, rivers, ponds and canals, etc. What is a groundwater? A groundwater is that part of the rainwater that seeps into the cracks and the crevices of the ground, that is called the groundwater. Now the presence of this availability varies in various parts of the country, depends upon the topography, prevailing climatic condition, etc. Now third one that we have is called the lagoons and the backwater. India has a very long coastline. It stretches around 6,000 kilometers. The coast is very indented, and some states like Kerala, Odisha, large number of lagoons have been formed. Lagoons and lake serve as a surface water resource. Although the quality of the water is brackish in nature, these are caused and are used for fishing and irrigation of paddy crops. Now, why is irrigation important in India? First and foremost thing is that India is an agricultural economy, and we know that monsoon is erratic and uneven in nature. Due to the uneven nature of rainfall, irrigation takes the most important role in our country. The natural resource, efficient use of available water resource is a key to agricultural development. The process of supplying water to the crop by artificial measures such as canal, wells, tube wells, lakes from the existing natural sources of water like river, tanks, ponds or underground water. Need for irrigation. Why there is a need for irrigation? India experiences a tropical monsoon type of a climate, unfortunately, which is erratic, unreliable, irregular and unevenly distributed. These variations of India climatic and make irrigation indispensable for sustained agricultural development. There are various reasons like uneven distribution of rainfall. Southwest monsoon is responsible for bringing rain in India. There is no fixed time to bring the rain in India. Large variety of crops also depends upon the various kind of rainfall in our country. Rainfall during 4 months is torrential. Some crops require more rainfall, some crops require less rainfall. That is why there is a need for irrigation in India, because all throughout the year we do not get the rainfall, and India is regarded as a monsoonal country. All those factors affect the need for irrigation. Now there are various methods of irrigation. Under the methods of irrigation, it has been divided into two heads. You can see that means of irrigation, we have primitive method, we have modern method. Under the primitive or traditional method, we will have the well, tank irrigation, canal irrigation. Under canal irrigation, two types are there: inundation canal, perennial canal. Well may we have surface well, tube wells. Surface wells are again distributed into two heads: line well, unlined well. Then we have modern methods, which includes sprinkler, drip and bamboo irrigation. Now let's start. What is a canal irrigation? A canal irrigation is prevalent in the northern part of the country, where the rivers are perennial and flow through a flat terrain. Now what are the conditions required here for making a canal? Low level relief, perennial source of water. The soil should be fertile enough to dig the canal. The water, broadly speaking, canals are of two types: inundation canal and perennial canals. Now what are inundation canals? Inundation canals are taken out of from the rivers without any regulating system like weirs or barrages at their head to regulate their flow of river. And in perennial canals are those canals which have water throughout the river, and they have the regulation of the water which can be measured and controlled through a weir, etc. Now we can see the difference between the inundation canal and the perennial canal. Inundation canal, it supplies water during the rainy season only, but perennial canal, the water is available throughout the year. There is no regulator To check the flow of water in an adhesion canal, but perennial canal, there is a weir or a barrage at the head to check the flow of water. Inundation canal, the cost is very cheaper to construct. Perennial canal, the cost is very high in this. Now, inundation canal irrigates only a smaller area, whereas the perennial canal irrigates a larger area. So this is what about the canals that we do. Then there are certain advantages and disadvantages also. Now coming to the next one, that is called the tank irrigation. Tank irrigation, very useful, which are dependent upon rainfall for their water supply. Tanks are constructed on areas of natural depression by building earthen banks, etc. Condition necessary, the favorable condition. Basically, they are more popular in the peninsular plateau of our country because it is uneven and many natural depressions are found here. The Deccan Plateau consists of underlying rocks, impervious, are non-porous in nature. Peninsular India receives monsoonal type of climate. Hence, these tanks collect water during the rainy season and helps for the irrigation purposes. There are again various advantages and disadvantages that you need to learn. The most important states where tank irrigation is Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, etc. In northern India, tank irrigation is prevalent in West Bengal, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. The next we come to the means of irrigation. The primitive method is called the wells. Irrigation by wells has been the old age phenomena by supplying water for domestic purposes and for the agricultural use and drinking purposes. 40% of the irrigated area is under the well irrigation. Now, well irrigation is further divided into two heads, that is called the surface well or ordinary well, and then we have also the surface well and tube wells. Types of wells are surface well and tube wells. Ordinary wells, surface wells, they are very cheap to construct and to maintain. They are unlined or lined. Unlined wells are known as kaccha wells and lined wells are known as pakka wells. There are various advantages of well irrigation and various disadvantages of well irrigation. Then we come to the next one, that is a tube well. Tube well, again, irrigation tube well has been done since ages. A tube well is a bore well which is helped with the drilling machine, and the water is pumped out with the help of electricity. That means electricity has to be there for tube well. For the construction of tube well, sufficient groundwater has to be available. High perennial supply, ground should be soft, adequate rainfall should be there to replenish the groundwater, cheap hydroelectric power has to be there, and it should not be extreme type of condition should prevail, the climatic condition. There are various advantages. It is useful during the drought condition. It can irrigate a larger area, about 400 hectares. It occupies less area as compared to surface well, and they do not cause any kind of a pollution. There are disadvantages also. It can irrigate much larger area than ordinary well, yet a tube well can irrigate only a limited area. The farmer has to spend a lot amount of money for regulatory of the electricity. This source of irrigation is not fit for areas of brackish water. In the event of drought also, it falls critically below the required level. We have modern methods of irrigation. One is sprinkler irrigation and drip irrigation. Sprinkler irrigation, you can see the picture. Under the sprinkler irrigation, overhead irrigation, this type of irrigation, sprinklers are used in the fields and can be supplied by water through the hoses from the source of water. It includes application in the form of spray, somewhat resembling the rainfall. There are various advantages and disadvantages of sprinkler irrigation. We have drip irrigation. Under the drip irrigation, the water is taken directly to the roots of the plants. A plastic tube is used which has small holes through which water keeps on dripping steadily. Hence, the name drip irrigation is given to this type of irrigation. The next we have the bamboo irrigation. The bamboo irrigation, it was in Meghalaya. The bamboo pipe can transport over 1000 meters, 100 meters of it. There are various advantages and disadvantages of bamboo irrigation. We'll continue with the next video for the conservation and the methods for conservation of water.